Abusive and sexist. That's how a former firefighter has described the work environment at Fire and Emergency New Zealand. She's one of five women One News has spoken to who say they were sexually abused or harassed while working at the agency. The organisation says it's already made changes following an independent report that found bullying and harassment were rife. But the women say they're still fighting for their allegations to be properly investigated. Imogen Wells with this exclusive report.
It's been voted the country's most trusted public agency 5 years in a row, but Jamie's experience with Fire and Emergency New Zealand tells a different story.
Sexist jokes, racist jokes, all the time. It's just background noise.
16 years ago, she says she was raped by a colleague while working as a volunteer firefighter. She was 22.
This was a person I trusted. I didn't even know how to process it because it was just such an unexpected assault. And then when I went to get help, nobody actually would listen to me or believe me.
Jamie says she filed a police report at the time and that the officer she spoke to was friends with her assailant.
He was like, me a disposable. He actually said that. That just made me feel so sick and so angry.
When she complained to Fire and Emergency,
senior officers just taking it in turns to just say hideous things. I put them in my police statement, but like I'd rather not repeat them because they're just,
Nearly two decades on, the organisation's apologised for how it handled her complaint.
Like, I accepted it because I'm tired. I felt very coerced and bullied into accepting it.
Nikita's experience, a similar one.
There was no push to try and get to the bottom of anything or to find out what had happened.
She says she was sexually assaulted by another firefighter 5 years ago.
What's happened to him?
Absolutely nothing. He carried on. His life got to be exactly what it was. Nothing changed.
Earlier this year, Nikita wrote about her assault publicly. She says it was only then her complaint was taken seriously. One News understands the man's recently been suspended, pending investigation.
I'm not bitter and twisted. I just want the people that need to be held account to be held accountable.
One News has spoken to three other women who say they were exposed to unwanted sexual attention while working for Fire and Emergency. One says she never complained because she wanted to fit in, but the others say they're still waiting for their complaints to be investigated years after they happened.
In 2019, an independent report found there's no doubt bullying and harassment features in FENZ workplaces at all levels and across all regions. The organisation's chief executive says it's already implemented some of the report's 33 recommendations and told One News,
I acknowledge and regret sexual misconduct has occurred in the past and is still occurring in this organisation. It is clear we must change our culture. We are making progress, but change takes time.
Do you think anything's changed since the report came out?
It actually made it harder.
One News understands fresh information on the organisation's assault and harassment complaints will be released soon. Imogen Wells, One News.